you before. Cosa la mira. I've waited a lifetime to show you once more. Don't go anywhere. Hello, sugar mommy, sugar daddies, boyfriends and girlfriends. It's me here again, Adiara, the multifaceted creative queen. Yep. Thank you so much for last week, love. Oh, I really do appreciate it. Top five. Your girl reached top five. Why was I calm?
He's going.
I don't know. I was calm with the intro. Why would I be calm? He reached top five. Like, I was at the back of Toke Makiwa. Me, Adiara, no. It's gone. No, I know, traces. Right? But I see they're the top challenger. Don't drag me, go 20 now. You should calm down. This one will be another banger, I bet you. From my mouth to God, yes. So, hello, everybody. It's season 2, episode 4 of the Cruise Connoisseur podcast. And with me, it's a full house, yeah? I've got fine men. You definitely know them. And I've got my closest friend, Laraba. They will introduce themselves by themselves. So my name is Adiara. You definitely know me, the multifaceted creative queen, the girl with different personalities. Laraba, introduce yourself, yeah?
My name is Laraba Suleiman.
And you are a farmer, a fresh graduate of Bowen University.
A plus size model. My graduation was last week, Saturday, on the 5th of November.
That's what you are proud of.
BSc, mass communication, period.
Welcome to now, your suffer continues.
Soon to be copper show.
I have with me K. If you've listened to Pregnancy Scare, you definitely know this guy that said, Pampas one, can you introduce yourself? Which is no sense. Who dash you?
So my name is Kerry. Everybody calls me K.
Yeah.
I'm a talent manager and logistics manager.
And
what?
They mention are plenty.
All the men.
And no.
Jebel, don't argue with me.
No, that's the pastor right there.
Bless you, my brother.
Hey, we have Jiggy. Heavy. Let me be your mommy. I told Jiggy, was like, I'm shy. I said, you cannot be shy on the Cruise Connoisseur pod. Never.
I left him outside.
And definitely. Jiggy, introduce yourself.
My name is Jiggy Lola.
I'm
a project manager.
Ooh.
Also, I own a clothing line called Jiggy Wears.
You guys should patronize him so that he will marry me. Thank you.
And after this, I'm going to take her out. So that
he's telling you that he's going to get married to me. He's going to get married to me.
We had.
I beg. You know that, yes, I don't betray you.
Judas
betrayed Jesus. Forget that. Introduce yourself.
What's up? Musi Day podcast. What's up, beautiful?
Like, I'm happy that it's even my podcast. This is my first.
This is my first podcast.
Can you imagine? Mom, like, I'm blessed.
I'd like to thank my mom, my dad.
Eleshi, what did you call the name?
Eshilokun.
Have you been watching this content? You know the sugar daddy. This is him, the real sugar daddy of Lagos. Ashiloku, introduce yourself.
What's up, everybody?
Yeah.
I'm Jimo Abdurrahman.
Mm-hmm. AKA Ramsey.
Known as Ramsey.
Yeah.
I'm a content creator, producer.
Tell them.
YouTuber.
Tell them.
Club manager.
Tell them.
And I do dabble in tech.
Tell them
tech
you were reality. Once a housemate in.
And I was once a.
Yeah. Tell
I was
them.
Once a housemate at a reality show called Niger Hood Rep.
Period. Thank you. So I reached out. Choke. I really choke. You over choke, Seth. He's gone. I'll be honest. They talk about.
No traces.
He come like saying,
"Now me be nobody for you."
You actually know she's a plus. I yash now even they see for Instagram. She's a plus size model.
What did this though? I know they shake your ass for Instagram.
So yeah. When I reach out to Ramsey, yeah, see, I'm this kind of person. I just like to reach out to people. I don't care because this is something that I love doing and I cannot be paying anybody because I'm investing in this. So I'm really blessed for having you. I'm not going to lie. for you to like reply. I screamed like, come on, he replied.
Even when he texted me, I was excited.
No, I was even excited that you replied. Like, oh my God.
No, because the thing is, I manifested it in my head. The moment I saw the last episode, I was like, I want to be inside this thing. So like, the moment I saw it, I watched the clip you guys posted, and I was like,
the snippet, yeah?
Fuck with this. I like, it wasn't one of those just drop it in the comment. I was like, drop it in the comment and drop it in her DM and tell her that
you want to be here. Everybody wants to be. If you know you want to be here, see, it won't take care. I won't charge you anything. Just come. Cause me, I even need people to come here, though. I really need people.
Just come with vibes.
Come with vibes. Be free, please. See, if you know you are shy outside, just leave the shyness and I'll come inside and be free. And
leave your manners outside.
I'm telling you, leave your manners outside.
As a pastor, yeah.
Madebel, we will do.
I don't like this.
Is it my looking at him? Let's go into the deal of the day. Today's topic is hot. It's hot because they are about to drag the women. See that they full ground. Because many of you will be saying that, it's only girls. Is it a girls podcast? No, it's for the men too. So that's why I brought them plenty, and I brought my closest friend here too. Because they're about to drag the women. So now we have to, I'm ready for them. Anyhow you drag me, I'll drag you back. So today's topic is 21st century dating scene in Lagos.
Always the drug rules.
The Center of Excellence, Abby. What's the slogan of Lagos?
Please don't have a Lagos person.
The first thing I'll say on this topic is,
yeah,
you are not in a relationship now.
Forget about it.
Forget about it.
You're crazy about this relationship. You know it's November. A lot of people's release
December.
Go scatter this December. You go trigger. And why JGB won't go now?
Oh my God, actually, I'm actually in Lagos. Where are you?
This Ikelodi, I'm landing in Nige on the 17th.
Oh my God, you have to show me around.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
I've been doing all the time. You have been watching my story.
She got a boyfriend for Yankee. Now you go be
IGG. I just
you know, Lagos is so different.
Lagos
was memorable.
I'm telling you.
January 2nd. Lagos.
Let me tell you something. They're using people's serious girlfriend to say Lagos was memorable.
I'm telling you.
You see the story. This is going to be the snap.
You know, I am serious boyfriend.
You'll be like,
like, hi, babe, what are you doing? Baby, like, I have a dick. I'm sleeping.
Which headache?
I'll call you back.
I want to eat. Babe, sorry, I've not been on my phone all day. Yesterday was so long.
Remember, the Lord is watching you. So wait, the first question is now, why is it very hard to find love in this Lagos? Why? What do you think is the issue?
Love has relocated.
And I lost plenty.
Love doesn't live in Lagos anymore.
So why do you think anybody can start? Because this matter is very, it's getting serious. Like, if I don't think God self can solve this.
God can solve it, but
it's getting worse.
It go long.
And the joke, you know, they get worse. People don't find love.
It's more difficult because, okay, on a normal day, relationships are actually transactional. Before you judge me, listen to this. Relationships, I said it before, we started saying, relationships are transactional in the sense that you're supposed to bring, you know, being intentional, loving, caring. Like, that's the transactional, reciprocating, you know, all those kind of things. That's the transaction. But Lagos, there's just two transactions.
Money
and sex.
Money and sex.
And that is the truth. Let us not deceive ourselves. everybody wants to fly to Dubai
flowers everywhere.
Everybody wants money bouquet.
Yeah.
And for the guys,
and they don't know that it's actually not like that.
The guys, everybody just wants to exactly
mm-hmm. and be so, dropping the money.
That's the reason why
I want to hook up now.
Look at it's the
hook up. It's not hook up. It's hook up. I like it when people say hook up.
Hook up.
Hook up.
So now it's woo. That means the woman.
Yes.
See, we have no.
I think that's the reason.
That's what you mean. Woo. Yes, now woo up. Woman. Woo up.
I thought I'm really like.
But so I think that's just the reason why it's hard because and then let's be honest.
Yeah.
A lot of women don't have anything to offer. Apart from sex.
Not me. A lot. Don't generalize.
Don't generalize. Men. I said a lot. I didn't generalize.
By saying a lot, you are still even...
You are still even saying we...
And because we're not going to...
Let's be honest. It can't be like saying now only me go support women for this podcast. No,
I'm here to support the men and the women that are right. If you are stating facts, I will support you. But if it's not matching with my this thing, I'm not going to support you. And then men, let's be honest. A lot of you men don't have anything to offer apart from money. And
not all though. So men can give attention. Ramsey,
I said
what?
A lot.
Ramsey, not
wait,
all.
No, I said a lot.
Ramsey, no, but
not
support me on that.
Not all men.
A lot of men don't have anything to offer. But remove money. What can you do?
9 out of 10 times, every time women talk about sex with men, it's always terrible.
Yeah, I don't know why.
No, sometimes I surprise them.
So like, I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, then who's doing
Ramsey,
a good job?
Well. Ramsey, mind the bell.
Like,
You don't test Edo man before. You are a man. Don't try. Don't be bad Yoruba. Yoruba, thank you.
I'm not just the women too.
No, I feel like Yoruba men can pamper women.
The gaslighting?
No, Yoruba men gaslighting.
It's part of it.
I'm different.
I'm very different. I don't cheat.
I say you lie.
I don't cheat.
Baby, you lie.
I don't cheat.
Stop it.
I don't cheat. I will never let you.
Ziggy, I've never cheated.
I've never cheated.
Ziggy, what darling? No. Don't get he look like a bad boy.
Cheat about when you're not even in a relationship.
She has shaken something.
My thoughts and prayers go out to you.
My bad.
So why is it very hard to find love in Lagos? Ramsey, sugar daddy of Lagos, please tell us.
I think when it comes to Lagos, my first opinion about, and it's, I think it's even a fact, is that we're not honest with ourselves. Like,
actually,
we love to lie. So now let me tell you what I mean by this. Is that good people. You see how we say things like
pretending. No.
Let's even break it down to something like, by law, homosexuality is not allowed.
Actually,
in Nigeria.
Yeah.
But have you seen the stats of people that watch porn in Nigeria? People watching that. So like, how is it not? It's like even going to artists that people cancel and say, this person has done this, this person has done that. I don't need to mention names. But if you go to those people's streams, they're still going up. So like, what I'm trying to say is that you see how people shout things like, they're doing this, they're doing that. But like, a lot of people in Lagos are lying to themselves, because that guy that is entering your DMs, most times, the nigga know he just want to f***.
Yeah, actually.
The girl too, really and truly, she may not really be feeling you, or she just wants to f*** and go, let me even gain some things from him.
Actually, so let's the money go. And sex.
But then at the end of the day, because of the way the narrative is set up, the girl will most conveniently come out of that the victim.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Once you're the victim, it doesn't really matter. Whether you check for his red flags or not. Mm-hmm. But like, 9 out of 10 times, and nobody can tell me this, like, if you have a relatively good sense of judgment,
mm-hmm.
every time you did see that red flag, don't worry.
Bro,
do you know how many TikToks people have made of? And when I see the red flags, what I actually see, and you see something else, don't worry. We're all agreeing on it now. So what I don't like in Lagos is that we like to
lie to each other.
That's what irritates me, because me, I've said it, I'll say it today, tomorrow, to the day I die. Mm-hmm. All of you in this Lagos, we all deserve each other. The men and the
yes,
women.
We are. Yes, we all I know deserve each other.
There are people that
they were made for each other. Please, I'm not in Lagos,
but they were made for each other.
I beg you, Benu Dake, why you not stay in Lagos?
The game in Lagos.
Now, yes, see, if you want to see a sweet man, is here. You want to see very sweet, handsome.
If you want to refer to the guy in the suits, you can just.
Yeah, he's my man. Then.
And he was
Kay, why is he hard for you to fight?
The gas.
Kay, he don't do. Please leave my man, baby.
Hi, love.
Kay, why is it hard for you to like find love in Lagos? Because I know you've been single for long, yeah.
So since secondary school.
He goes to drop out.
You know technically, that means you've probably just not been in love.
Yeah.
Because if secondary school is your last memory of love,
since when?
That means you people have not gone out.
There's a like huge difference loving somebody and being in a relationship with that person.
You can okay, love being in love.
That is why I said
we are going there. Yeah, there's a difference between
the relationship is just the thing I've not really fancied, because one, I'm this type of person that I don't fuck with stress at all. Any small stress, bro, I would run. So relationship definitely comes with stress. There's nobody that has it smooth.
Yeah, you know, go rosy now. You know, go rosy, but it depends on the level. Okay, I'm not ready for the headache.
You don't want any form of that.
That means you don't want picky. You don't want get away from the talk.
Okay, I just text the okay.
But do you want to get married,
bruh? See, now don't lie. I'm still considering not getting married.
Please, I bet there's power in the tongue.
I'm not lying.
I hear you.
You don't subscribe to the school of marriage.
It's what? Okay if you don't subscribe to marriage or you don't want to get married. It's fine. Mm-hmm. But I feel like why? The reason should be because, okay, a personal reason. Not because everybody's married.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I think he's looking at other people's...
I think they're looking at...
Yes, that's what he wants. If it's for Kayode, I feel that's what he's looking at.
Don't feel worse, Lara.
I get what she's saying. She's trying to...
Based on childhood trauma. Based on childhood trauma.
No, you're not childhood trauma. It might not even be what he has seen.
Yeah.
Like, he's not just a celebrity. But childhood trauma still... If he's still there...
Banging other niggas and stuff. No, I'm not just ready for that stress.
But truth is that for me, I'm actually like afraid of marriage. And the reason why I'm afraid of marriage is because I hate divorce or separation.
Take your ring.
Wait a minute. Let me buy this ring for when they come.
I'm actually like afraid of divorce or separation. That's the only reason.
You have to remove fear. You have to be positive in life, baby.
With the way you women are going.
With the way you men are going.
You wake up in the morning. Like, okay, for example, now you're in love, so in your head, you're in a relationship.
In your head. That's your first problem.
Like, okay, both of you are in a relationship. It's going. And she has broken up. And she has broken up with you.
In your head.
She has broken up with you in January.
Let me tell you something.
Both of you are sitting in your head.
Men do that too.
No, women do it more.
Men do that
too. A man will see.
They will break up with you. You go day relationship. You know what I'm saying? Only you day.
See, when a man has broken up with you in his head, you will know. Do you know why? Because the things that he has been doing for you before.
Make we no lie. He talked true for dear.
But when a woman has broken up with you, you don't even know.
He talked true for dear.
You are just doing everything. You are going everywhere.
I think women are very good at pretending.
Yes, I don't lie.
That's why you hardly catch women. Like, I'm not saying you cannot catch women cheating, no.
They do it better.
I don't cheat.
Like, generally women
I don't know how to cheat. I love my man.
There's a girl that I've seen that she literally left her man, went to someone I know and said, I'm still going to sleep with you in this Lagos.
She has a boyfriend.
Wow.
And she walked back to her.
In this Lagos.
Told him that you've been avoiding my messages, Abi. Don't worry, you're looking fine, Sha. I'll still sleep with you.
And she has a boyfriend.
Okay. Yes.
Okay, that's somebody that told me. Somebody told me that thing. Like, my babe just walked to the front. I'm single. My ex just walked.
Ah, sorry.
Single. I'm a single girlfriend.
I hear you. My thoughts and prayers go out to you. I felt that. I felt that.
Can you have me laugh?
He said, whoa. Slow down. You're single.
Jiggy, I want to ask you something, babe. Do you still love her and you still have me?
I saw you, naturally, because
I mean, the last relationship I was in, even though we didn't call it one, it's a relationship in my head.
Okay, I was about to say, you didn't.
I'm still very much feel a certain way about the babe. So like, it's not. I don't think those kind of feelings go away just like that.
Like, I really want to hug these guys. I don't know, genuinely, for me, there's a difference between
And love. I woke up early in the morning. I'm doing pancake. Then I realized that the person
you know, that's one thing. You know that's one thing about me. There are certain things that if a guy is doing, I hate that pancake. Muscle memory. My guy was making it, but he's like, wait.
Like, I'm serious. Like, I woke up at 4:30 a.m.
4:30
a.m. Oh, okay. Let me quickly.
The last time, I don't know, I had to turn the parquet.
I was like,
so are you, wait, are you guys now saying that women are the main issue here?
No. I think we've gone to a point where now everybody's convinced that you're for some reason going to even get 99%.
Actually,
you're whining your destiny.
You're whining your father's destiny. That's life. I think that's how God has generated you. You don't get all in one.
Oblivious to a lot of things. Like, yeah. Whether you like it or not, first of all, you're not perfect.
Second of all, whoever you get all not in one.
Perfect. So let's say in your head, you have some like 10 marker shit of, oh, this guy has to tick all this thing. Mm-hmm. Omo, if you find someone that ticks five, go and look at the remaining four and see that four. Think about the four. Think about the four and
see.
Yeah, think about the four. I'm not saying the, you know, oh my God, thank you for giving me five. But what I'm saying is, go and look at the remaining four and say, can I live without this four? Can I manage?
That's exactly this four. That's what I used to say, it gets some kind of flaws when you feel managed.
Man, like,
if bruh, you pass your power,
I hear the weirdest things, man. Someone's telling me, oh, if my man is in TikTok, I can't talk to him.
Like, forget bro, that. Really? If you TikTok, that's the big money, no go see that.
That's what I'm saying. Like, if he's making money for a lot of
wait.
I can't date comedians.
You've never seen an Iclis before.
If he's always in Zoria,
but that thing was killing me. I can't lie.
You guys, if he's out to club every Friday,
all those kind of things.
I have something to say. I don't see any reason why a man will say, I don't want a woman that cannot cook. And then we cannot say, I don't want a man who is into the entertainment industry.
If he TikTok,
hold on.
If he TikTok, they bring money, no consider.
So wait, there are two things.
You don't like,
If you're a comedian,
there's a very big chance that at the end of the day, if you're not popular yet, you end up being popular. There are people that don't want that spotlight in their life.
That's a very terrible comparison. Do you know why? Can you do? Hold on. Can you do without TikTok? You know my point. The point I'm trying to make is that you can sustain.
I did not say TikTok. I was talking about the comedian thing.
And what I'm saying,
I'm saying some people don't really like people.
Wait, I want to say something. My friend is a graphic designer. Yeah, and he's like, he has been. No, he's not getting money, like big money, but any work day, me, I even they try push work for her. Yeah. Then the girl now their relationship, oh, the girl now went to, God forgive me, say the third boy, everybody this way. The girl now went to MBJ. She don't see how, you know, boys have been spending for their girls and everything. Now the girl no can win with the whole stress and
everything.
They know what they are coughing about. This girl no can win. The girl did not win, then she came back.
Oh, she didn't.
So she called the transfer aggression to the guy. You understand that kind of thing now? Yeah. The girl, she asked her for money. See, the girl said, I'm owing blah blah stuff like that, this and that. Give me money. The guy say, she gives you 500k. Then the guy said, I'm with my salary with the old debt of 500k. Say, I don't get that money to help you. Then the girl say, cause I say, this graphic designer job, is this the only thing that you would do? I felt for him.
I felt for him. The relationship has ended now. You knew me before you went for
him. He's still in the relationship. I say love him.
There's some things that like guys do, and like everybody just wants to. And again, yes,
men police what women want to do to us. But like on the topic, because on the topic right now is we're talking about men. And like there's so many little things that like people say, oh, guys can't do this, and if you're doing this is the ick, if you're doing this, like I think about it, I'm like, man, if I'm dating you, there are lots of random things I do. So what are you telling me? Not be me. I should be
more. Yes. You want to go there?
Okay. Just get the drink.
Just get the drink.
Why? Then why they come to the club?
No, they like. Why am I going outside? Like, women like that.
Don't you want me to have?
They like. They like.
Women just like.
They want like that. Okay, they want top G.
Yes, that guy does be.
No, I think I like men like that, but that doesn't mean like you don't like, you will not be nasty.
No, there's a
There's
a difference between being
uptight. Just know. And being uptight for where you are. You know, just know how to behave where you are.
Yes,
you understand?
Yes.
If we go to the club, are we going to the club to go and clap hands? Let's dance.
It's like saying, the one thing I would never catch myself, if I go concert, maybe you can't control it. Walk.
No,
there is no reason.
You said you can't stand that TikTok one.
So like you now, you said that TikTok.
I said TikTok.
Honey, you did say that TikTok one.
No, you said both. You said TikTok.
You said that TikTok one. So now me, I'm now giving you the dancer.
She's a dancer now. I'm not saying change that person. If you don't like a particular thing about that person, don't go for the person. But you have the right to say, I don't want a guy that likes TikTok.
But do you think?
Okay,
you think
yes, you have the right to, but that doesn't mean that you should now say.
Let
to
me.
Leave.
I'm saying. I'm not saying. I don't like a guy that likes TikTok. There are people that do TikToks that actually okay. Oh, but then they're saying you see all those people that will put filter.
Okay, they I can't lie. There are some, guys on TikTok that are very cringe.
No.
I'll mention one.
Ah, no,
good. I know what you're about to say. You just don't worry about this.
Okay.
I don't like this. I don't like this agreement on this guy on TikTok. But you know what? I'm just going to
say. If you don't get it, forget about it.
Like.
So, and then in my defense, you see that trenches dance. I don't do it in public.
I can't lie. You know, there are some trenches people on like TikTok that I can't lie. Their shit is funny.
You can't date somebody that's like, you know.
No, but in public.
You can dance. So I'm not saying you can't dance. But in Kotimo Sonic, it's about Jade. First of all, I don't even like concerts like that, but Tabalo concert.
But there's nothing bad there.
No,
it's actually being weird.
Don't get me wrong. You can throw your vibes, though. I'm not saying have fun. Because somebody now is going to say, oh my God, Ronnie's saying women cannot have fun. Have your fun. But a boring time is not for you. So I'm not, you can go to concert and go and do a boring
time. But in front of you.
But like,
you
know my own woman. You know my own woman. First of all, my baby's probably too thick to just be doing a boring
time. Oh, nah, lie. If you somebody like me, my dog, I would dance it.
What do you have against that song?
Don't let me, this. Okay.
What do you have against that song?
A boring time.
I don't know how to dance.
if you knew how to dance, it would be illegal.
Please, let's not go for God.
Distracting everybody.
Have you seen yourself?
I'm sorry, my bad.
No.
Yeah, I've said this thing before, that communication,
is key.
We lack it.
Actually.
Everybody just want to go off for anybody and that's all. Like, I don't want to be with you. These girls can just go off. How am I even supporting going against girls? I said I'm supporting girls. I'm going against them this time.
I think it's not about girls. It's just about what is right, what is wrong.
I think this statement of, like, communication.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very big on communication. And I think, like, a lot of people just did not grow up in a very indulging space. And what I mean by this is, I mean, I'm the last born. And I know what it has taken from me personally to go and learn how to communicate.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody in my house is old. Like, the person I'm after is like damn near 10 years older than me.
Wow.
I didn't grow up in a space where I felt like I could say my mind. Mm-hmm. Like, even nowadays, if I meet somebody that, like, I'm talking and this person's listening, mm-hmm. Jesus, you've already had me small. Don't worry. I mean, like, the fact that you make me feel comfortable enough to say my mind. I don't share my mind a lot. Even with my people, like, Raman is going through it, but, like, nobody knows.
He's just going to smile.
I know Raman is going through it, but he's not going to tell me. And that's, it's a me thing. But the point I'm trying to deal with this is, it's from time. Now, where I'm going to fault a lot of us in this market is that you need to take responsibility and go and learn that shit.
Exactly.
Because if somebody sees me now, like, if we're talking about this, and someone's like, ah, how are you able to... It's not my mommy and daddy that
taught me. It's not. You have to just stick with
it. I went to go and fix that. So, like, I hate... And I'm saying this because nowadays... Every time you just see people say, oh, why'd you do this? Oh, it's because of my trauma, X, Y, Z.
Yeah.
Is that trauma? Don't get me wrong.
Before someone cuts this
the wrong way, the point I'm trying to make is that, before, yes, your trauma does affect you in different ways.
Actually.
But you need to heal.
Exactly. You need to heal.
When it comes to communication on you, a lot of us in this are poor market.
Someone told me that.
You see TikToks of kids nowadays that you say, oh, mommy, I don't want to do this. And the mom explains to you that you have to allow them
say that.
Bro, so like all these kind of things, it trickles down to us too. But man, go and fix yourself.
Go and heal.
Many of us haven't told you that you don't know how to talk. Then try.
But then you said nobody that, okay, wants to try. You didn't grow up in an environment where your parents are communicating. Your parents did not teach you. Your parents did not teach you. That's the reason why you are not single. You, this girl, if you interrupt me, I will. Okay, so
you want to display your madness.
Sorry. Oh my god.
No. I like it. But yeah, you were saying.
Everybody say, oh, I grew up in a toxic environment. I don't know how to communicate. My parents did not teach me.
Do they not teach people how to communicate?
That thing that you are doing under the bed sheets.
How did you learn it?
Did your mommy and daddy teach you? You learned it. They did not teach you. But you don't know communication that will help you sustain that thing you're doing under the seat to continue to your marriage.
I cannot breathe.
The things that you people are doing, I don't know.
I cannot breathe.
It means that you might be selective.
I cannot breathe.
This love thing. Like, when it comes to like this love thing you're saying, I think people need to shake off this narrative of love is just rewarding. It's not rewarding. It's like when people have kids, like some people have kids and they're thinking like, oh my god, my kid is gonna, it's a job.
Actually, like,
if you're going to fall in love, you're not going to fall in love on the level of step. Oh, he has to have 10 parts, he has to wake up in the morning and fry rice, he has to send me $10,000.
You have to see flowers.
Like, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying these things are wrong.
Yeah.
Like, if you go in with that notion, you're whining yourself. Because first of all, you also have to check yourself. Like everybody for some reason, and I'm not saying there's anything wrong with, you know, saying you're the
parent. Wanting all those, yeah.
I went to caramel books.
What she called the girls rats. What did she call them?
Is it rats? I think it's rats. The example she gave is okay.
You say you want a hen.
It's this babe's birthday. Then I go all out, I buy a lot of stuff.
Designer things for him.
Then your birthday, she gets you singlet and boxers.
No, okay, let me. I was like, okay, me, I will always do it, but she did something on my birthday. She bought me a TV.
Wow.
Guy, I went to look at all the list of women I've dated and the ones that maybe just once.
I know how you feel. In my friend group, I'm the biggest mug in my friend group. Like, I'm the one that collects the most disrespect from babes in my friend group.
Yeah, I'm a simp.
Now, the only thing I'll tell you is that with every disrespect, I did learn a lesson.
Actually.
Because I'm not going to change the person I am. Like, if I meet you, I know how I interact with people. I don't be aesthetic bad boy. So I'm not going to do that. It's stressful. Like,
actually,
I'm just not built that way. I'm the kind of person that wants to tell you that, oh, I went to your third post and I saw what you posted here. I want to say make things her, the way I am.
Yes, yeah.
So like what that. You will not do, the last person not going to do is going to ruin my impression of the next person. So like, I know what that has done for me for the long. You know when you meet somebody and you're like, wow, this is standard. I don't think anybody can beat this. Mm-hmm. My first ever ex did that and it took time.
I
met like maybe a couple years ago, and I was with her. This babe made me realize, I mean, it wasn't the sweetest relationship, but like it was memorable. I mean, shout out to her. She did save my life.
Shout out to you, baby girl.
And all, like this
babe did show size.
See, this is a man supporting women. That women are good, though. No, can think
women are good. Women are good. Men are good also.
Yeah, women are good. Women are bad. Men are bad too.
But wait. That babe, she leaves me.
No, she's not really.
Forget that.
Okay, for me, Lagos, for me now. For me, see, Lagos.
If you talk about Lagos, don't limit your market by that statement. Do you know?
But why did you say they are different? No, you want to strongly.
TikTok one babe posted recently, where like she said she's a 10. Someone thinks of her as a 10 in Lagos, and then she's a 2 somewhere else.
So like the point. No,
the point I'm trying to make is that don't limit your market. Lagos is a very dirty market. If I'm being honest with you, like everything, like genuinely, like the moment I saw this topic and I saw dating scene in Lagos, I was just disgusted because everybody's just whining themselves in Lagos.
No, we are like, all whining ourselves, like, but people are still.
I hate the way Lagos market is set up.
People are still.
And everybody just wants to lie to themselves.
Well, people are finding love.
People say they find love.
Really. It's just 1%. In a week, it's just 1%. In a week, when you go out, how many friend groups do you run into and they tell you, oh, this person is relationship? It's always, she's talking to someone. Something.
There's always something. Because we're all scared. Because we are scared.
Yes, now, but it's part of it. Like, okay, now let's even fashion like market being terrible. There's so many people that always tell you, oh, I want to fall in love, but I'm scared. Nigga, it's part of love. You have to risk. Like, okay. Where did you hear that? You love, and, bro. And even people that believe, even in your religious belief, there's a story of people there that did certain things that could bring them ruin, but they did it. You have to take that risk. So like all these thing. Like all these years of people always saying things like, oh, heartbreak, oh, you are good. It's part of the mix now. What did you expect? Like you don't appreciate light unless there's dark, no?
Actually.
Pastor comes. Pastor runs.
But the thing is, I used to really appreciate, like, I don't know how you people that do it from one relationship to another. You people have strong heart, though.
Well, like
one so relationship to another.
I'm of the opinion that, yeah. if you come out of a relationship and then in a month's time you jumped into another one, you are either not dating that person you were with before, or you're hiding your childhood trauma or something. If you're with somebody that you genuinely fuck with for a year and all of a sudden that has ended and you're able to jump into another, there are people that I've even met and I've connected with them for just a month and it feels like I've known them for so long.
So,
and
no,
I
can't imagine.
You're going to tell me that in a month's time, in a month's time of a routine of over how many months, I've just changed that routine and now every day I pass Lekki, this babe's house is on the express. I still look that way by default. So you can't tell me that somebody else, you tell me in a month, you're good and you're ready to jump into another. You are damaged. You need to take time out. How can you enter a relationship for so long?
I feel like if you leave a relationship of like 2 years, let's say you break up like last month, and this month, they're already knocking on that babe. I don't know. I feel like something is wrong.
That one, you are following me to Tori.
I'm serious. I feel like it's just like you broke up.
Ramsey, don't attack me. Thank you.
Last month.
He's still healing. Don't attack me. He's still healing.
Because my girl was like, guy, go knock. Everything will be all right. And I'm like,
That's terrible advice.
I'm like,
but you knocking after like things like, okay, so with the way I think human nature works is, you see, when things happen to you, I think you need to not, it's like when it comes to like being in a sad place or feeling depressed, I don't have any medical knowledge because I don't want to use that word in the first place, but if you're in spaces like that, and this even is personal, by the way, there are places you've put yourself in that you have to choose to get out. I saw a tweet on Sunday, and it was like, when you get heartbroken, stop listening to SZA and listening to all these people. It's going to put the notion of heartbreak when you can listen to, I mean, I don't know all these like really beautiful love songs, but why not listen to a love song that can tell you
because
when you're listening to heartbreak song while you're heartbroken, all your body is going to collect it. Oh, it is more depressing.
God, we are very good.
Have you listened to my husband's The point I'm trying to make with you is that, yes, your friend gave you bad advice, but like you going out to having sex is something that is very possible. There are women that could be having a terrible time and then they go out with their friends, they're having drinks and they meet somebody. They may not want to sleep with that guy, but they may enjoy the time with that guy.
No, I can understand.
So it's like saying you want to deprive yourself of that. Yes, some people term sex as enjoying their time.
If I have sex with someone, I'm trying to make her happy. All right. Like, I know that when I'm done,
you've been.
You want that? Fire around!
And that's very good.
This guy cannot.
I don't want a relationship.
I'm not leaving alone.
Okay, so what you're saying is that for you to have sex, like, it must be like deep connections.
Yes, I must feel not that the one of Anak. Don't be a shell now. I'm not cute.
Oh, you want to have a deep connection with the person?
Like, let me see the person. The person is still my friend, but I just see the person and I just smile. Not the one of.
He cannot relate.
This one. He can't relate.
So entitled.
Case on it. The Uber is downstairs.
Yeah.
Soon, all of them are delaying out.
No. Please, entitlements.
Mr. Kaode.
Now, entitlements. Yeah. That's the next question. Have you spoken about it?
No.
Entitlements in Lagos, really, in relationship. What do you think? I think it's getting out of hand these days.
Yes,
all of we are. Yes.
I meant to entitled.
Yeah, both of them. In sex. When it comes to sex, yes.
Not even just sex. I've heard of some animals asking this for money.
What do you mean, really? Sex. Entitled to?
Oh, yeah.
Sex.
Attention, men like attention. No,
men do like attention.
The person that they don't like,
some people just feel that they are. So when you say entitlement, does not have to just do with money. Some people just feel that they are entitled to your entire life, everything that happens around you. I mean, I can tell you.
Entitlement right now, we're referring to like
that one is now obsession.
When we say entitlement, we're referring to like, okay, now me and you we're dating. Let's again, for just the lack of better understanding, let's all acknowledge that. Dating does not mean people are in a relationship. Dating is that you are seeing each other.
Sex, yes. Like that was so I told you that
a lot
time.
Of things are involved in the mix, okay?
Yes.
Now, we're not going to take this to entitlement. So, while you're dating, who is more
entitled? Exactly. Women, definitely. Now, make we no lie, Sha. Make we should not deceive ourselves.
It's in that dating scene where you see a babe complete. If you let a babe understand that you're still talking to someone else, she's going to make you feel bad for it.
Actually,
she's probably doing the same thing too.
Women can play mind game.
So like, I don't understand. Like, I hate this whole dating scene where like everybody makes it seem like when you are dating, you are the only person I'll talk to. You may be the only person I may be having sex with at this point in time, obviously, or you may be the only person that I'm sharing certain things with.
Yeah.
But you are definitely not the only person in my space. Do you know why? I am dating.
Okay.
I'm trying to see whether this could work, which I expect that you should also be doing.
But you know that. But you know that in this our Lagos,
because people want to make you feel bad. Because exactly. At the end of the day, they'll say, "Oh, so we've been talking for all this time." Yes, we've been talking for all this time. I'm still trying to get to know you. I'm sure I'm also communicating shit
that I like or don't like. I'm sorry. Nobody should come again. Women will definitely come, but please, I'm sorry, I don't fucking care. But the thing is that the reason why women, we are giving ourselves heart attack and headache, is because we are mistaking dating
for relationship.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then I think there's dating exclusively.
Yeah. After you start dating, then you now move to dating exclusively. That is when people know that you guys are not still in a relationship yet.
Yes.
Yes. Can I ask a question? Are you saying that dating is like talking stage?
Basically.
Serious talking stage, you're not how are you fighting.
You know my problem. Do you know my problem? My problem with like when dating gets to that point is that you now start to hear babes say things like, "Oh, he hasn't asked me out. He hasn't done this. He hasn't done that." Now the response should be expected for me to say, "Why don't you ask him?" Now, this is the problem. When somebody is not saying certain things, if a guy is evading certain topics, bring it up. Now, when I say bring it up, it's for your own good. A lot of times I tell my female friends, like, you tell me you like a guy, but he hasn't said this. Then bring it up. Be like, okay, what's up? I would like for... There was a babe I've met recently. She said, you know, so-and-so is what I expect for my future.
Yes.
This is this and that.
Yeah.
Now, do you know why it's good that she did that? If I know I can't give her that, is that...
Communication, that's what I like.
Now, my problem with babes is that, I don't know, maybe they think they are not entitled to their own opinion or something because it's your like. Now, your like you carry, come bring me.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not in control of your
I
like.
I think it's society
so
that
work
comes in
for
there.
You.
Yeah.
Yes, I know society has not allowed it, but again,
we'll see.
You have to go and learn. That's not my job.
It's very hard.
Is it hard?
Not all women, but it's very hard for me, Adjara,
to say
it's
that.
It's because a lot of people don't want to look like a mug. That whole fear of, exactly. Oh, I mean, I'm telling him I like him and he doesn't like me back. But do you know what? But you see, that's the thing.
I've done it before.
Everybody makes
see,
it look like it's embarrassing. But yes, you, it do you know why? Do you know
it is embarrassing. But
the romance that people perceive as romance in Lagos.
Yes, it's not.
This dating market that we're even talking about, guys, filled with a bunch of people that most times when you see their relationship cycle is restaurants, hotel, snap, club.
That club
that's
night
it. Night
that's
it. Night, like that's your romance. Night. Like that's genuinely, that's I want better. Hotel I want room. Better for my people. But like that's Ramsey. Really it.
Ramsey.
And like again, most of the people that will provide that kind of romance, they're in their damn near 40s for you and doing fraud that came from Chequeteri, God knows when.
Actually,
the money they're going to spend really on you just that. And like you now see somebody in that situation complaining, and then when you now say you want quote unquote love, I'm not saying that most guys that can love you are broke, but most guys with that kind of capacity don't have that purchasing power yet.
Yes, actually.
So you have to pick. And again, that's why I say, like, see, I have no problem if you want to live your life as per, they should break you up, they should ice you out, go for it. But most of the people that are going for that breaking up, most of the people that you're getting broken up, you're getting broken up from somebody that you know cannot give you that sort of
love.
So just take one. Like right now, all you
think love should be built.
I remember when I
build love.
That
God
fits and also have that.
I really thought flat.
Most times, the nigga that you're trying to send memes to and laugh and pull up on him at 2 a.m. is not the same nigga that has that kind of money right
now.
I promise you.
Exactly.
The one that has that money right now, he won't reply you, where are you? The driver is coming to pick you. Goodbye. That's the guy you're going to get.
I said,
dating love. Most of you are not even dating. Most of you
actually
are transactional. You are new level, new generation.
I need you right now. Come home.
It's new generation. I don't know what to call it, but like, it's not dating. Like,
so yeah,
really, like people know they date for Lagos.
Actually, people know they really date for Lagos. We do not deceive ourselves.
What is really dating?
Nobody. Everybody just wants where he has one less stress here.
So that I'm not chop breakfast. So that how many breakfasts have you really chopped?
So next question, yeah, going out on a date here with your spouse in this Lagos here, who should split the bill? Should they split the bill? English hard, madam.
It depends.
When
if you're saying your partner,
some Lagos girls would like the best to split. Somebody like me, I'm sorry.
But someone like me, I don't think
this is a debatable question. The nigga should always pay.
Do you understand?
The nigga should always pay.
Okay, so now
let me tell you where we're talking about again dating.
Yeah.
Okay. We're not talking about relationship. Me and you still
dating.
We never.
Yeah.
I'm trying to prove myself.
I don't think a guy that if he especially when he initiates it, any guy that has a problem with paying for the food he said he wants to take you out to eat,
even your own friend
should tell you, ah guy, let's go and chow. That your friend should know in his
me
head that I'm buying you the food.
No, excuse me.
I'm not saying don't have your money or
exactly.
Don't. Yes, always. Again, that's a no-brainer.
Always, exactly.
It's a no-brainer.
Very
like,
funny.
I'm getting to 2 points here.
Okay.
I'm getting to people. As a guy, nigga, please, have your money up when you want to take somebody out.
Mm-hmm.
But as a babe that is dating someone, as far you are seeing the person, he's not your father.
Mm-hmm.
He's not your family relative. You should, in the back of your head, just have it that, should in case so...
Let me hold my own money.
Because a lot of people in their head, they're like, why should I have money? Why should I pay for this?
Say, is it not the one I said I should?
I don't want embarrassment. Some babes now overdo it. So, don't let me use insulting words, but... You take them out, bruh. You say we'll feel I'm saying you take person out.
The
they would buy what they don't like. If you're getting something when somebody else is paying,
please, I beg, I want to talk something.
You cannot tell
you. Yeah,
want
to talk something. So I've been seeing this guy, yeah. We're not seeing like seeing, yeah. We just used to. This was a very long time. This was a very long, like, let's say, beginning of this year. Not dating, we just used to talk, see, talking stage, but nothing. I love you, talking stage, but I never even bought a way to touch you, because I don't even like him. But the first day I met him, so I was like, okay, I want to like he said he wants to take me out on a date. So he came from the mainland down to the island. I'm like, me, Adiara, I don't like stress. Don't be saying I don't like good thing. But I told him now, KFC is not far from my house. Check out Losibe. I don't have my card, sir. But you go pay. Say, KFC, I know the KFC. 4,500, 6,2, all different size day. I go say, okay, let's go there. I like to respect myself. I don't say now you they pay. We reach counter. Oh, yeah. What should I take? I told him, okay. He asked me how many chicken. They asked me for how many chicken. I looked myself from there. I said, Aga, how many chicken should I take? And the guy say, me, if I say four. The guy say, no, give her two.
It's killing me. Like, wow. Baby.
Wow.
Brother.
He like say, make
wait,
wait,
so imagine if he just went to another restaurant.
Say, I'm not saying that he's broken anything, but I felt embarrassed. Like, I say, me, Adiara, where they work out, they vest, yes. They go, okay. Because say, my car, David, I say, Jesus.
Yes.
Wait, Angio.
Some people don't have the money.
Do you know
facts?
No, but what she was the one that suggested KFC and he wanted to go to somewhere better. Imagine if you now went, what would you now think?
I hear you, but you know that he's still better than a lot of Lagos women.
I'm still better than a Lagos.
He's still better than a lot of Lagos women.
Women? How?
Lagos women.
They will not buy anything.
Nah, lie, yo. Eh? I've gone out on a date with a man that said, take that, more, baby.
Again,
take
more. For this specific guy, yes, definitely.
He was asking me, are you fine? I'm here coming to be fine. You won't have the guts to ask me for fine.
Calm down. Ah, you don't suffer.
I'm going to do that for better, for worse.
But wait, the game is not giving money now.
KFC is not far. It's not far from my house.
Money. When did he come out?
Exactly. When did you come out?
No, I mean, they look. No, he came to pick me from my house because me. If you are taking me out of
this, I didn't ask you.
That's one thing guys do that it stresses me in this Lagos. Like when you see a body or a babe of a particular standard on the internet, you approach her. The moment you get to a babe's Instagram, and I'm not saying judge a book by its cover,
actually,
but like you should fake know, life all you of have us. you have your own price charter for your own head, and you can see this girl's own. If you can't afford sex, and I'm not saying you can't afford Aspa, Aspa, just be able to do the things that you think she's accustomed to. Girls are accustomed to different things from different life. There are babes that I know right now that in their head, they don't understand why they would go anywhere without the security behind them. There are babes that, in their own head, they can't sleep without lights. You know, everybody has, the point I'm trying to make is that everybody's accustomed to different things. There's some people right now that if they tell you that they've taken lights, they can die. So like, I'm saying,
no facts.
As you're doing your assessment of getting to either run this babe's pee or whatever, you know that she will give you markers.
Actually, yeah.
Like, okay, take for it. Example, me.
Then you now see some nigga come on the internet and say, "Eh, she's a gold digger, bro."
For example, me, my babe cannot stay without lights. If you meet a lady that is above you, leave her alone. Then don't. If you now go and meet her, she gives you this is how she is. Then you now come back to complain. Then something's wrong with you.
Because it's our time of dating. It has got to, we should not lie. All of us will be ashamed. All of us, we are just fucking them money.
If you know that.
Yes, I was telling somebody that social media said now it costs time. We don't lie. Because in the time of our parents, social media no day. It was smooth, firm. Everybody know say, no, because, this is the right thing. But now social media don't to deceive us.
Brought out unrealistic standards.
I'm telling you.
If you are setting standard, that you cannot meet up to.
Yes, then
don't try it.
For when it comes to like men,
sure also meet up
people have this. Men have created the standard that okay, babe should look this way, or her stomach
exactly
has to be
flat.
You know, she gotta be thick.
You have to drive this. I see, like a perfect man should have all of that. I used to think,
No, but like that's the reality of it is that nobody can have all those things together.
Actually,
one. But
you'll
two,
get everything.
You may find people that have those things, but you can't be putting your standard out like that. I'm
what
not
can
saying
you grow
lower your standard. I'm not saying
sorry.
I'm not saying, you know, lower your standard. That may be your standard, that's fine. But what I'm saying is that if you see what you see in front of you, stop whining yourself to collect what you are seeing.
See, here. Exactly. Many of us don't want to grow with a man. That's
again,
what, many
most of the people that always quote unquote look for that are here. Like, why? Like, you'll be seeing. Do you think that, and this is for guy or babe, if you're a babe that your bag is up, yes, I know people say things like, you know, rich babes are intimidating and all of that. Yes. But guess what? You've intimidated the trash away.
Yes, actually.
Now, the men that are in your pool market may even be more viable. I mean, I'm not saying they are the best.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is that, stop all this.
He has to.
I would like for my woman to have money. Why?
Please.
Because so that when
I can do house husband.
I'm not saying I'm not talking about doing house husband. When your money is up, first of all, the richer you get, the more closer you are to your
actually, yeah.
All this, like, yeah. That's why, like, now poor people they talk past.
Yeah.
When you are like, when I talk about money again, I know some people make it like, I'm not having money does not mean that as per I'm now rich. I mean, like, money improves your taste. So, like, if I'm somebody that this is how I like to treat women, or this is how I'd like to, you know, interact with a woman, once I have my money up, that's what I would do. So you think if I have that kind of money, I'm still going to be talking to somebody that expects, like, as per her basis of interaction with me is that, oh, you have to pay for my ride to come and eat.
You are not
my target market. Yeah. Because now I'm going to be around women that will probably say, don't worry, should I get my driver or your driver?
Why are you wasting time
talking about, oh, this guy is broke? Get your own money up. This is our conversation here about dating. It has been circled about money.
Yeah,
and
entitlement.
Doing this entitlement. We've not even spoken about, is that person even emotionally intelligent?
Yeah.
Does the person have the ability of discernment?
For where?
Does this thing have longevity? Does this person even have a goal?
Like, I feel like if you have not reached a certain amount of comfortability
in your life,
don't be in a relationship. Yeah, it's our time. Like, don't just be in a relationship. Work on your career.
We're talking about mid-20s.
Mid-20s.
Most of these people just came out of uni.
I'm telling you.
Everybody is horny.
I'm telling you.
Everybody's problem is that. My problem with everybody in Lagos is that you don't, like, a lot of people just want to fuck in this
Lagos.
But, like, you people just want to be the victim while you're fucking. Like,
exactly.
Everybody wants to be the person.
That's why you hear guys say, hey, babe, do this one. Babe, two, say, like, both
people
of
you are just funny.
I've said it, that if you're not in a relationship now, you are whining yourself. Looking for a relationship in this level, you are whining yourself.
But the sad thing, people are still...
It's transactional on a terrible basis.
Yes, in this world.
In honesty, love itself is transactional. But this particular form of
if
transaction.
If it's not
yes, I mean, generally.
I'm not even about love. They're about what they are getting.
What am I going to get after?
He sends me 200K for this.
Only people are lucky showers.
You don't think money can, like, push you to love someone?
Money can, no man, no con life for them. Money can push me.
Let me.
If you know how to use the money,
if you know how to use the money to, you know, I can fall very
soft.
So embarrassing.
Women
are so embarrassing.
No, you just wrote the narrative. Uh-huh.
Change the way you feel about him.
You said can money make you love a guy? Yes!
Money can make you love you. You like, there was something they should have said for every love language. They said something that you like.
Can I say something?
Say it and let's end the show.
If I like you, I like you. Yes. If you have money, it is a plus. Thank you, Jesus. If you have money and you don't spend on me, thank you, Jesus.
Okay, so,
okay, so calm down.
What
calm
are the
down.
Things that you would like then? Like, what are the attributes that would make you like him?
Chocolates.
Excluding the money.
Excluding
vacation.
Someone who communicates. Someone who's emotionally intelligent.
Actually.
Someone
has a goal.
Someone who has a purpose. Clarity.
Yeah.
Okay, so,
someone who has a vision.
Can communicate.
Someone who
cares about me. Yes. Because we lack communication.
Someone who's intentional.
Do you think in the pool of men around you, do you think there's any guy that meets that up right
yes.
now?
Yes.
Are you
please, you know
guy?
Who? Thank you guys so much for listening. I really do appreciate it. Thank you, Kayla, Ba, Ramsey, Jiggy. It's a very long topic. If you had stayed here, we will not finish, I swear.
We'll give them
we will not finish, I swear. Because thank God we're able to get some. Hey, we will not finish.
So, summary of this whole topic is stay single.
Stay
guys.
Single.
No, not stay single. You will
stay
find love in Jesus. Don't listen to this man, though. They will see propose. In the next 1 year, they will see propose to somebody and say, will you marry me?
Propose.
We have come to the end of the show.
Me, I'll propose.
I'll
like,
you.
Love still exists.
In case.
But not in Lagos.
He don't do. Say not in Lagos.
Yes.
In case you need their handle, Ramsey's Instagram handle will be on the screen. Kay, Larva, yeah. You guys should follow up. Follow their business support. Thank you so much. We are young creatives. That's the English. Thank you so much. If please do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Say hit this button, please. I beg you. Let's reach 1,000 by the end of September.
Subscribe.
Yeah. Yes. 1K. Subscribe, please. I beg you.
Please. We need go Dubai.
Exactly. So I can take my girls for vacation. You yeah. Please. Thank you so much for listening. God bless you. Do not forget to subscribe. Please. Let's hit top five again this week.